Yeah! Look at these poor bastards. They flocked here thinking they'd be safe, that the royals would protect them. But the establishment looks after itself, no one else. God helps those who help themselves. Never forget that. Upside down. That's a distress signal. Maybe they're still alive inside there. Yeah. Prepper here. I'm pretty sure there's an old Raven's shelter nearby. Might find what you need down there. What a bloody mess. Sure, God save the Queen, but it looks like the plebs wanted to go along for the ride. as your way in. Be careful. Radio signal won't reach you down there. You're on your own. Don't mess around with those. Pull the pin, count to three, throw the bloody thing away. I know you're green as grass, but try and remember to aim before you shoot. This is the last great plague. The ravens are restless. The signs are here and the blight is upon us. Just like the Magus D foretold. But never mind that for now.
Dear John, I'm sorry, but I just don't think we're going to agree on this point of... Dear John, I'm sorry, but I just don't think we're going to agree on this point of interpretation. You seem dead set on a scorched earth reading of the BP, whereas I, and Ron, and many of the others, see it more as a warning that we need to help people, not stand by and watch as it happens. I know you're angry with me and Ron for arguing with you at the last meeting. Advocating a better safe than sorry approach. It's like global warming. If we're wrong, well, at least we tried to make the world a better place, and no harm done. But if we're right, and we don't act quickly, we're putting the whole planet in danger. I wish you could see that. We're not trying to shut you out or shout you down like you suggested. I know you said those things in the heat of the moment, but even if you didn't mean them, they hurt. Your experience is invaluable to us. That's why I was asked to recruit you in the first place. But we're not children, and we do understand your point of view. We just disagree. The Council has asked me to suggest you take some time off from the meetings, because they don't feel you're being productive right now. I'm not going to do that because I still love you, and know how much being excluded from the Council would frustrate you. But I agree this fatalist agenda isn't productive. I'm about to leave for Clermont-Ferrand to see what I can dig up in their library about the Physici, as discussed at the last meeting. But I'll be back in time for bonfire night, so I'll call you and we can go up to Ali Pali for the display. It's been too long since we spent an evening together, and I'm sorry about that.
Thank you.
Lovely woman, the Queen. For an ancient lizard posing as a human, anyway. But I tell you, she knows the score. It's the government didn't want anyone to know about Dee's prophecy, not her Madge. I hope they get her away to India or something. Their climate's better for reptiles, anyway. There's your way in. Be careful. I won't have eyes on you down there. You're on your own. I'm losing you. Must be shielded. Watch your back.
Thank you. did you get in here? Oh, never mind. You're clean, aren't you? So you must be pretty good. Well, perhaps we could help each other. Sorry, I should explain. There are security monitors and speakers in the walls. I'm Peter Knight, junior doctor to the royal household. So don't worry, you're not going mad. Do come and find me in the lab, won't you? Shame about this chap. He couldn't handle the horror, you see. Then again, maybe he was more sensible than the rest of us. Sorry, I know these corridors are a labyrinth. But, well, that's the point, you see, to keep intruders out. I suppose I should warn you, there are also a few infected roaming around in here. Used to be Omega Group soldiers, you see, but... well, they're all infected now. Terrible shame.
Ugh!
Do make yourself at home. But please, don't touch anything. This is all vital scientific work. I'll close the door behind you, just a precaution. Sorry. It's safer for both of us, you understand? I'm researching a cure for this terrible infection, you see. It's slow going, as I have so few subjects to test on. Like those poor Omega Group soldiers. Not my finest hour, I fear. If you'll forgive me for a moment, I'm sure you can help me. I say, steady on, old girl. Right. Now here's how you could help. There's a book, De Remedi Secreti, by Conrad Gesner. A fascinating text, but what I'm after is Dee's own copy where he made annotations. I believe it's in the palace library, which means going upstairs, I'm afraid. Would you be so kind? The bunker elevator can take you up to the palace. Did you see any ravens outside? Not our feathered friends, I mean those awful survivalist types. They actually believe John Dee was some kind of prophet. I hope you don't mind the music, by the way. William Byrd, Elizabeth I's favourite composer, apparently. I find it helps me work, it's very soothing. You're doing ever so well. I do feel awful about the poor guards. Well, technically, I'm an Omega Group myself. Started as an army medic, and then they posted me here. It's such a shame. Those soldiers were an elite. It's so sad to see them like this. Thank you. I've just realized you probably have no idea what a mega group is. Top secret, you see, but that hardly matters now. It's an elite group to protect the royal family. But the outbreak caught us on the hop, and now all these poor men who used to guard the bunker... Well, I suppose you could say they're still guarding it. If only we'd paid more attention to Dr. D.
Patients succumb immediately to infection in the region where the malady enters the body. Violent convulsions follow, and their veins turn black as ink. Poisoned blood radiates from the wound, spreading like the roots of a venomous tree, accelerated by unnatural haste. It would be beautiful, if not for its dark design.
but that you can definitely use, especially in this bloody place. Nice and quiet.
In some subjects, pockets filled with a rich, acrid pus form near hot, inflamed area of the groin, armpits, and jaw. I have extracted this liquid for further investigation. The patient must be not be calmed by any manner of herbal sedative. She seems ravenous, and nothing I feed her can satiate her monstrous appetite. As if compelled by a most foul instinct to devour all life. The patient must be restrained and cannot be calmed by any manner of... The patient must be restrained and cannot be calmed by any matter. The patient must be restrained and cannot be calmed by any manner of herbal sedative. She seems ravenous. And nothing I feed her can satiate her monstrous appetite. As if compelled by a most foul instinct to devour all life within her reach. She freed herself of her bonds yesterday and would have gutted our horse alive if I had not reached her in time. I find myself in awe of the piteous state to which man is reduced. A walking conduit, a mere empty coil, which lives only to feed its greedy and carnal instincts.
Where was I? You must forgive me. I'm a little distracted. Ah, yes, Dr. D. John D was a scientist, alchemist, natural philosopher and all that, to Elizabeth I. Some people say he was even a spy. was I? You must forgive me. I'm a little distracted. Ah, yes, Dr. D. John D was a scientist, alchemist, natural philosopher and all that, to Elizabeth I. Some people say he was even a spy. Imagine that. And D wrote a warning, you see, about this outbreak. Oh, dear. Sorry, must dash.
Following the recommendations of De Remedi Secreti, I reduced the pus to a dry powder and discovered that injecting the concoction into the subject... God forgive me that I refer to my own wife as subject... causes the black blood to retract and wither. I glimpsed the flush of my wife's once rosy complexion through the sickness. But alas, she then succumbed to one final fit. And at last, with blessed mercy, ceased moving forever. May God have mercy upon her soul, and allow it now to rest. I remain convinced this volume offers practical methods for obtaining a solution. Perhaps even the key to save us all. angel chided me thus. Ignorance was the nakedness whereby you first were tormented, and the first plague that fell upon man was the wanting of science. The want of science hinders you from knowledge of your own self.
So you found Gesner's book? I do hope it wasn't too much trouble. I'd pass it through, would you? Ah, wait. There's something else. That gadget of yours looks rather like something the Omega chaps used to carry. Would you step over there and scan that infected chap with it? A full scan and analyze, mind you, to isolate the infected gland. The human body really is a fascinating thing. Even after all vital signs in the subject cease, the body continues to fight the infection. Amazing, eh? Thought so. You'll have to put him out of his misery first. Then take the syringe and fill it up with antibodies from the infected gland.
Yeah.
syringe will synthesize a viricide, a sort of poison, quite deadly. There's enough for one injection, but you can refill it from another willing volunteer. In return, I need another favor. A second book, Studium Contagione, a study of infection by Dee himself. It's very rare. But I happen to know Ron Friedman has a copy in his flat on Brick Lane. Ron's one of those raven chaps, you see.
If you can't run, you might as well lie down and die. Always keep something in reserve.